Hi, my name is Dr. Adam Kittai. I'm an associate professor at the Icahn School of Medicine at Mount Sinai, where I'm the associate director for clinical lymphoma research, and I'm also the CLL leader. So the area of unmet need, in my opinion, in CLL remains Richter transformation, when CLL transforms into diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. And the main reason that is that it appears that patients with Richter's transformation continue to do poorly in the era of modern therapies, where in patients who have received small molecule inhibitors and no chemo, how we treat our patients with CLL who develop Richter's transformation in the current era continue to have a median overall survival measured in months, less than 1 year. And so in the end of the day, we need to do better by our patients with Richter transformation by developing novel therapeutics. Now, over the last few years, there's been multiple targeted agents that have been developed for CLL that are now being brought to Richter transformation. So there were three publications recently published that showed that some of our new therapies, in fact, probably do work pretty well for Richter transformation. One was Pirtobrutinib, the non-covalent BTK inhibitor that recently got approved for CLL after two prior lines of therapy. Another one was combining Zanabrutinib, the second generation covalent BTK inhibitor, with the PD-1 inhibitor tislelizumab, otherwise known as Tisli for easier pronunciation. And then there's also CAR T-cell therapy for Richter's transformation with a recent publication. So let's start off with Pirtobrutinib. So what's nice about Pirtobrutinib is that it's a pill, you take it orally, has a good safety profile. And for these patients who had received two prior lines of therapy for Richter transformation, they did quite well with a median overall survival of 1 year and a PFS of around 8 months. And so you might say, well, 1 year is not good enough, but this was 1 year in patients who had received two prior lines of therapy. So really these patients didn't have anything else at the time. And so in general, what I'm using Pirtobrutinib for patients with Richter transformation as a way to get them to a more aggressive therapy, typically allogeneic stem cell transplant or CAR T-cell therapy. But it still remains an unmet need to get these patients to allogeneic stem cell transplantation because it's tough to get them into a CR, and also these patients tend to be older, which is tough to give an allogeneic stem cell transplantation. So this is where CAR T-cell therapy may have a role. So in a recent study that I published in JCO, we did a multi-center effort and we took patients who had received standard of care CAR T-cell therapy for Richter transformation. And what we found, once again, in these patients who had two prior lines of therapy, that the median overall survival was around 9 months. But once again, these patients really didn't have anything else, so 9 months is actually not so terrible. In addition, those patients who had attained a CR, and that was about 46% of patients, had a durable response, where these patients had a duration of response of 27 months. So in a good chunk of patients, they have a really good durable response, which suggests that we should be using CAR T-cell therapy for Richter transformation more. In addition, in a multivariable analysis, we found that patients who had received more prior lines of therapies did worse, suggesting we should be using CAR T in earlier lines of therapy for Richter transformation. The last study I want to talk about is the Zanabrutinib plus tislelizumab study. So what's interesting about Richter transformation is that it does have a high expression of PD-1. And so there have been prior studies that have looked at the combination of ibrutinib plus nivolumab. So this is kind of like the second generation of that combination, which looked quite good. So in this study that was published by Dr. Al-Sawa from the German group, they had patients who majority did not receive any prior lines of therapy for their Richter's transformation. So about 80% of those patients had received no prior lines of therapy for Richter's transformation. And when they implemented this combination therapy, the median overall survival was not reached at the current data cutoff. And a lot of patients are still receiving this therapy and doing quite good. And those patients who did progress on this therapy winded up getting chemoimmunotherapy, which is likely why their overall survival looks pretty good with this combination. So overall, I think that there's encouraging data out there using our new medications for Richter transformation, but we still have a lot of work to do to figure out how best to treat these patients. And this disease continues to be the area of unmet need for patients with CLL.